Mission Marvel.
Aunt May! Phineas and Ferb are making a crossover!
Doof's power draininator bounces off Phineas and Ferb's space station and hits the Avengers, draining them of their powers. I guess this is after Banner turned into the Hulk one too many times and was unable to turn back, just like he appeared in Ragnarok. So he's still the Hulk, just not strong. So while Hydra uses Doof to get to the heroes, the Avengers team up with Phineas and Ferb, and S.H.I.E.L.D. teams up with Alka to set things right. This was the first big project announced after Disney bought Marvel, and it mostly draws from the Marvel animated television universe, using its cast, including Chi McBride as Nick Fury.
I'm going to proceed as if this were going really well.
But it draws a little from the Marvel cinematic universe as well, featuring a few visual homages to the Avengers, since that was the biggest movie they had to go off of at the time. But it does sort of inadvertently predict several future MCU moments.
You know, Stark Industries offers summer internships.
Thanks, but this summer's pretty packed.
So give me the hammer. What do? I just stick out my hand, right? Come on, baby. Come to papa.
That is not how it works.
What do you mean? I've got your powers.
Wielding Mjolnir is about worthiness, not power.
You think that was Howard the Duck?
Time is of the essence. We've got to... No, it wasn't Howard the Duck.
What? I'm just saying.
He did have a bill.
And it predicted several conversations we're still having about Marvel media.
None of the women superheroes showed up, so it's all about testosterone and towers and fighting.
All I ever do is quips. Like this one, for instance. And the one preceding it.
Can we please not kill the gravitas of this moment?
Sorry.
There's plenty of references sprinkled throughout to all sorts of Marvel media.
I've always told her, don't ever make Phineas angry. You wouldn't like him when he's angry.
Is your head gonna burst into flames, or am I thinking of somebody else?
And a few references to things that aren't Marvel, but are still fun references.
Oh, the rustic exterior is a facade. Wait till you see the inside.
Oh, man. You guys are good.
Just a little British sci-fi technology.
Top of the world, Ma!
As a Marvel comedy special, it's a lot of fun, and it's worth watching just for the brilliant casting choice of Danny Trejo as Venom.
Was he bitten by a radioactive platypus?
And as a Phineas and Ferb special, it's pretty good. It's a nice sequel to The Beak, now with real superheroes involved. It's a little controversial for being the meanest we ever see Phineas be to Candace, which, yeah, is a little unsettling. And I get it, the stakes are high here, and she did mess several things up, but come on, dude. It's partly on you for not giving her better instructions. That said, considering how often Candace gets annoyed with Phineas, even when he's completely oblivious to her annoyance, it is an interesting exploration of a role reversal, and it does nicely set up a very sweet reconciliation at the end. Isabella's arc also seems a little underserved, like it doesn't really set up that she's feeling this way until she's about to sing a song about feeling this way, but at least her underserved arc is used to address the underserving of the MCU's non-male heroes. But Buford and Baljeet get a few nice moments together as we finally hear Buford admit what we've known for a long time.
I worry about you, you know, because you're my best friend.
God, I'd hate to see how you treat your enemies. Hey, if Marvel characters have always existed in this world, has Buford been wearing a Punisher shirt this whole time?